have that much speed in an icy wall, you can hurt yourself really hard.
You just kind of had to hold on and survive, so that's what I did.
Try and go big.
You feel like an eagle in the sky, something like that.
One of the best feelings in the world. I would just like to survive this event. Survival in a bigger contest is the key to life.
It's kind of fun. It's kind of weightless feeling for a second. Just a lot of fun.
After sun, a couple of beers and sleep. Women! Don't forget women.
Don't forget the women, yeah.
I just said to myself, it's good for my motivation to fight until the end.
I think I had a pretty good run. We'll see how it holds. You never know.
Welcome to Mont Saint-Anne, Canada.
Gotta make it.
Well, today the judges are working on a new judging format. It's only been out just this season, and it's going to work on, each judge is going to have his own actual category that he's judging. And one judge will be judging on amplitude and level of excitement in your run. Another judge will be judging just on takeoffs and landings. One judge will be working on rotational tricks. And one judge will just be working on overall airs and an overall impression of the whole thing. And I think it's really going to help out because I think the judges will be able to concentrate more on exactly what they need to look at instead of one overall impression for the whole day. So I think it could really help.
You're going to see definitely some changing this and other types of competitions until they figure out a format in snowboarding that is easy to judge.
Rock and roll.
It's a brand new venue that we're seeing our regions all around the country get involved with. There's the term jib and bonk and what all, and that's kind of working the terrain as you see it, getting out into the trees, having some fun with the mountain as it is.
Professional sports tour would be possible without a grassroots program to introduce the younger competitors to the sport.
my brother taught me how to go and pump the sides and stuff and get big air, and he taught me all my tricks.
Was not really good here. We had some really warm weather yesterday, so the pipe melted, and today it snowed inside, so the pipe was really in bad condition. So the show was not really good, unfortunately, but it was a competition. It's always good to win, though.
We'll be right back.
you're involved with any type of big air event, the biggest thing you really want to concentrate on is being real confident with yourself. If you don't have the self-confidence of dropping in and going 2.5 meters, then you're not going to make it.
Up, I guess, a lot of speed, just hug yourself as high as you can go.
Surfing. Tried to sail my windsurfer down the street full of snow, it just didn't work. And somehow I got into snowboarding, and then it was like I had to do that all the time. And so I just go up and go snowboarding every day after school and spend my weekends up there snowboarding. And I just, things just got good and took off and decided to compete and did what I had fun. You know, I got like a fifth place or whatever, you know, but I had a real good time. I feel like my goals came to me a lot quicker than what I was ready for. Just all of a sudden, it seemed like I was world champion and decided to do it again. And I didn't really set myself any new goals, just wanted to enjoy what I was doing and, you know, kind of enjoy what I've worked so hard for all the time rather than just being so focused and stuck in my pit of, you know, winning competitions and just being, you know, the baddest snowboarder I can be.
Yeah. big, big holes and rats, and underneath it was icy. So whether you were in the hole or you were on the rats and ice, so you had to fight from the top till the bottom. Only the last few gates you could let the board run and you could fight. And under these conditions, it's really difficult for everybody.